bridge recording of Life Above Zero, making mindset manageable, health holistic, spirituality science, and life liberating. Written and read by Lauren Kerr. This book will equip you with the practical skills and mindset, backed with the psychology, research, and statistics to help you unlock the code to success in your life, relationships, and career, with some positive, warm, and fuzzy vibes thrown in, sprinkled with tough love. Introduction. I want to start by thanking all my teachers and mentors. A special thank you to my biggest teachers, my beautiful parents. Thank you for giving me the biggest and best gift I'll ever receive. Unconditional love. Because of you, I know how to give love, but I also know how to receive it. Because you believed in me, I have believed in myself enough to live my mission. And because of you, I can inspire others to live their life above zero too. I am grateful for every person who has crossed my path and enjoyed a little slice of my experience in this beautiful world. And for those who have either taught me a lesson, been a mirror to reflect my own bullshit, or held a safe space for me to fall over and pick myself up again. I am a committed student of life. I am a result of the people I talk to, the books and studies I have read, degrees and courses I have completed, and the universities and conferences I have attended. Do you ever feel you read books and attend conferences and they're all saying the same thing, but in a different way? That is because leaders leverage off ideas and resources, and success leaves clues. You can't skip the awkward learning curve, but you can definitely shorten it by learning from those who have gone before you. Unlike what some badass may have advised you, rules are not made to be broken. Follow them. There are universal laws you follow if you want success. For example, if you want to be healthy, move and eat well, right? If you want to have money, spend less than you save or create. Do you want to be successful in business? Celebrate small wins with gratitude and persistence. This is the code to unlocking success in your lives, relationships, and careers. Stand on the shoulders of giants. The student always outdoes the teacher. Nothing in this book is original. These ideas and concepts have been passed down for thousands of years and are the universal laws that govern all the life around us. I am fortunate enough to have stood on the shoulders of giants. So this is my gift from them to you. A quote from Woodrow Wilson. I not only use all the brains that I have, but all I can borrow. Chapter 1. What is life above zero? I am so thrilled to have you here, and I trust the universe has an intention for you, ensuring this book crossed your path for a reason. Before I freak you out and you pop this book back or you return it to your friend who reads way too many self-help books, yes, I am a massive believer in universal laws, one being the law of attraction. If that is not something that also aligns with your beliefs or you think that that is all a little too woo-woo, we have a whole book yet to change your mind. Please know, this isn't just another self-help book that promises you all your wildest dreams will be served on a silver platter if you think about it often enough. Instead, this book will equip you with the practical skills and mindset, backed with the psychology, research, and statistics to help you unlock the code to success in your life, relationships, and career, with some positive, warm, and fuzzy vibes thrown in, sprinkled with tough love. You're probably wondering, what is life above zero and how do I live it? Well, first, I need your commitment to be real and raw with yourself. Whatever comes up for you in this book, know you will only get out what you put in. It's hard when someone expects you to open up and trust them if you don't know a little about them. So let me go first. I've always felt like I had a mission in this world. I learned early on in my teenage years to let go, trust my gut, and follow the pull. There is so much research about this you will get to find out about later in the book. I told you there was lots of juicy stuff in store for you. My gut instinct has pulled me in so many directions over the years. Different education and courses, different jobs, different romantic relationships, social circles and friendships, and even different countries. My biggest tug was from my gut when I was 17. I felt the pull towards the sunshine, towards new experiences, new depths, and new lessons. Ironically, the pull towards it all was so strong, you would be forgiven for thinking I was running away from something. But that wasn't quite the case. I was being pulled away from so much unconditional love and support, pretty much everything I've ever known. Away from my comfort zone, my beautiful loving family, mum, dad, two younger brothers, and my pug Jellybean. My high school boyfriend who I thought I would be with forever. My friendships, and that town on the river that had been my playground and a haven for 17 years. Everything. If I'm honest, reflecting now, and I think even secretly I knew it back then, I was running away from something. Running away from the fear of mediocrity. I'd been with my high school boyfriend for nearly 4 years. We were head over heels for each other. Ah, first love. I thought I saw how the rest of my life would pan out. Easy, predictable, simple. Our own little fairy tale. Oh God, how naive was I? He was a year older. He'd gotten into a university in Canberra, and the plan was he would have a gap year while I was finishing year 12, and then I would follow him to Canberra because I would hate being apart. We would venture and conquer life together and live happily ever after with a couple of kids somewhere close to our families. We were both simple people who found fulfillment in the small stuff and had similar values. This plan seemed common when you fall in love in a small town. I've always looked up to my parents. I love the marriage they have. I love the family they've created and safe haven they designed for me and my brothers, especially when I knew that one in two marriages ended in divorce. They are teenage sweethearts and had been together since my mum was 14. Not without their rocky patches. No marriage is immune to them. I just wanted that, and I honestly thought I could have easily had that. I knew what marriage gave my mum, the connection, the love, the belonging, the security, both emotionally and financially. Shared memories, shared laughs, shared tears, and shared pains. I knew it took hard work, commitment, mutual respect, patience, and compromise. I was lucky to have and still have a close relationship with my mum. She is my best friend. Mum was open with me early on and would try to pass on her wisdom so I could make the best decisions, saving me from some of that teenage heartache. That is what all mums try to do in the best way they know how. If you are a Gen Y baby like me, chat to the older women in your life and ask about the values and expectations of women in that era. Women could go to a university and pursue their passion and careers, whether it be consciously from their family and friends or unconsciously communicated and reinforced via magazines, books, and movies at the time. One thing was certain. It was more widely and traditionally expected that women would follow their partner's business pursuits and be the homemaker. Sure. There were some brave and courageous women who broke out from that mold, like many still do today, and girlfriend, I salute you. But that was a compromise my mum made. She loved my dad so much, and she abandoned her dreams and her career to be with him and accommodate his. Not that he ever asked her to do that, but it's crazy what we do for love. I guess, for me, as much as I loved my boyfriend and the future we planned together, The fear of the compromise I had to make to fulfill that white picket fence dream scared the shit out of me. The word beamed down on me again. Mediocrity. Risking that life together was scary, and man, was the journey that followed a painful but beautiful one. Risking my independence, adventuring, exploring, and pursuing my own career was scary, but I knew the pain of regret would have cut me so much deeper. If it was meant to be, it would be. Holding on to something so tightly in fear of losing it is only an attempt to demonstrate ownership of it. Let it go, and if it finds its way back to you, it is yours. It always has been, and it always will be. Looking back now, I realize how arrogant it was of me to use that word, mediocrity. I now know life takes guts, courage, hard work, magic. Not that it was mediocre. Destiny had a different path for me. Also, it turns out I was too selfish to compromise. I am embarrassed to admit it, but this is exactly what I want to encourage you to do as you read this book. Be open to recognizing the not so pretty parts of yourself and courageous enough to own them. There is nothing wrong with staying in your hometown and living out your fairy tale. I guess I just wanted something different. Not more, not less, just different. Leaving probably was one of the hardest yet most powerful decisions I have ever made, and it drastically changed the direction of my entire life. Moments like these are called pivots. Moments in your life, one event, one person, or one decision changes everything. I am committed to consciously creating a life I love. I refuse to believe life is happening to us. Instead, it's happening for us. You're in the driver's seat. Get involved and have your say in the creation process. The life you currently have is a direct reflection of the decisions you've previously made. Want a better life? Make better or different choices. It's as easy or as hard as that. Sorry, but I warned you there was no silver platter service here. I made a decision and I busted my little butt off studying in year 12. I'm not naturally smart, but this girl has grit. Another thing I'll teach you about later in chapter 6. I got a scholarship upon my graduation to study psychology at Griffith University. The first in my family to go to university, I moved as soon as I was 18 to the sunny Gold Coast in Australia. A new playground to explore, a new lifestyle, new friends, new education, and the famous Cavill Ave. High heels, hot nights, vodka, the cheap stuff. Dance floor, more vodka, toilet, vomit, repeat. This was enough excitement in itself. Being just 18 and a girl who loves to dance all night, I tried to mend my broken heart. So with that, too, came the excitement of new boys. By the way, if you're heartbroken and wanting to try that life, I don't recommend it. Save yourself the awkward and embarrassing walks of shame. And know the only way to put a broken heart back together is by doing the work and learning to love yourself first. There is no quick fix. You can't find someone to do that for you. But I promise, more on that later too. So why psychology? I've always been passionate about helping others and wanted to leave a positive impact on the world to ensure my life would not be lived in vain, that I served others, left a legacy behind, and the world was a happier, better, more educated, connected, and accepting because of my presence. Health is holistic and is just as much about the mind and soul as it is about the physical body. There is power in learning how to understand and control our mindset instead of allowing our mindset to control us. I loved deep and meaningful conversations. I was that awkward person at a party who wouldn't.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.